What's up, y'all? This is your boy JG. You know, I got the cool pose a little bit because I'm by myself today. No AB in the building, just JG, but it's still all good. Exaggeration experience, big fights this weekend. Showtime Shawn Porter versus Errol, the true Spence Jr. We get into it right now. Let's go. Welcome back, y'all. This is your boy JG. Like I said before, no AB in the building, but this is an exciting one. I'm keeping it short. We're going for under 5 minutes. I'm going to try to cover as many bases as possible. We're talking about the upcoming bout. By upcoming, I mean tomorrow night, September 28th. Errol Spence Jr. versus Showtime Shawn Porter for the unification, the 147-pound championship. IBF, WBC belts on the line. Let's get into it right now. There was a narrative that was created recently that Errol Spence couldn't knock out Shawn Porter because he didn't knock out Mikey Garcia. I was just looking at some numbers. I should have off top, but you're looking at the record right now for Showtime Shawn Porter: 30 wins, 2 losses, 1 draw, 17 KOs. For Errol Spence Jr., you got 25 wins, 25 knockouts. So I'm not going to do the math on that, but in 25 of his bouts, he's knocked his opponent out 21 times. I wouldn't be too caught up in worrying about what did or did not happen to Mikey Garcia. If you're Shawn Porter, you have to worry about the fact that this individual has almost knocked out every single person that he's fought at 147 pounds. Shout out to Mikey Garcia. He got a dope ass chin. He got hella heart. And he gets out of the way kind of sort of sometimes. Good footwork. But that's more of a testament to Mikey Garcia than it is an indictment for Shawn Porter, or excuse me, Errol Spence. The other things you have to look at is Errol Spence has been ridiculously dominant at 147 pounds, mowing through a lot of his competition. He put on a boxing exhibition against Mikey Garcia, which was fantastic to watch and see. If you look at the other side of the coin, you look at Shawn Porter, his last 3 bouts, I believe, are a loss, a Danny Garcia victory, and a Ugas victory. Throw in, I think, a Andre Burrow or somebody was up in there, some terrible fight that nobody was checking for. But he's been in competitive bouts. Danny Garcia, a dope boxer, trimming his left hook. He's not supposed to be taking you to the brink. If you're Shawn Porter, a 247-pounder, I think that's been one of the issues primarily with Danny Garcia at this weight. He might not be a 247-pounder, but doesn't want to make the weight at 140, but that's another conversation for another day. So how do these guys stack up? We know that Shawn Porter can be a second-string linebacker in the NFL. He loves to tackle people, lead with his head, do the most, cut guys up, make it rough and tough, and for the most part, he's always in shape. Wide shots, when he tries to box, he gets in trouble. He should work to avoid that. Matched up against Errol Spence. Errol Spence can do it all, really. Punch, box inside, box outside. Inside work, body work, upstairs, downstairs. He can punch you out of the ring. He can explode your liver. Shout out Ocampo. Shout out Dallas, Texas. He got his liver exploded. What is Shawn Porter going to do? Because I know that Errol Spence has different avenues that he can take and pursue for this bout. But what's Shawn Porter going to do? We saw him pretty much get outboxed by Ugas. That was a close decision that could have went either way. He was in spots and outboxed by Danny Garcia. He wouldn't let his hands go. So ultimately, he ended up losing that fight. Even in that fight, though, Shawn Porter had to switch it up against Garcia and turn on the gas because to simply box, that wasn't going to work. So what does he do against Errol Spence? He stays on the outside. He tries to box me cute. He's getting beat the fuck up. It's going to be Kenny Porter, his pop, standing up on the apron, waving the white flag like, please stop hitting my son in the face repeatedly over and over and over again. If he goes on the inside, you're not going to be better, in my opinion, than Errol Spence Jr. on the inside. He's a vicious body puncher. He's a menace. He bullies. He throws a little pry in there, the little forearm pry, to create space, and then he digs you the body. So where you may have been comfortable in other spaces and places bullying other guys or imposing your will, like, you know, bootleg Ray Lewis, this is not going to be the place where that takes place. Errol Spence is too big and too good for that. Moving down for the rest of the card, and I'll give you my prediction when we get done. Two fights I don't want to mention, the David Benavidez-Anthony Durrell fight. That's for the WBC strap. Benavidez had the belt, lost it due to non-boxing stuff. Durrell picked it up. It was a vacant belt. Now they get to figure out who's the man in the division. Both have been ridiculously respectful, which is dope. So they'll just settle the differences in the ring like men. Fun fight of the night is going to be Josecito Lopez versus John Molina Jr. That's an incredible bout because these dudes play no defense. It's going to be blood and guts. I don't see it going the distance. John Molina got that big-ass head. Josecito Lopez, good power. And we're going to figure out what it is. going back to the top, my prediction for the Errol Spence Jr., Shawn Porter bout, 147-pound unification, IBF, WBC. I got to go with EJ, my man's, Errol Spence Jr., and I got him getting it done convincingly. I'm looking at a ninth-round stoppage, either ref stoppage, TKO style, or Kenny Porter up on the apron waving that thing around. But you guys definitely get into it. Like I said, Staples Center, L.A., September 28th, Saturday. Should be fun. Good Night of Fights. The undercard is dope. You guys definitely check that out. This is your boy, JG. No AB today. Double M still putting in work behind the scenes. And this is what we do. Exaggeration and experience. Holla at your boy. Like, subscribe, bell icon for notification. We out of here. Rest in peace, Shawn Porter.